This video will explain how to classify coarse grained soils. Coarse grained soils are typically sand or gravel and they have no plasticity, so we call them non-plastic coarse grained soils. This example is taken from my book, which is called Saw Mechanics Through Project-Based Learning. If you still don't know how to draw a grain size distribution curve, we also call it particle size distribution curve, please watch my video on YouTube. In this video, I explain how to conduct this test, how to obtain results, and how to analyze them. The link is given here. There are three major steps that we need to follow to classify a coarse grained soil. The first one, we need to determine the amount of each fraction. So we need to know how much gravel, sand, and fines in the soil. And second step, we need to determine the gradation of solid particles. And once we know both of factors, then we can classify soil using flow charts or any other classification systems. The first thing that we need to do is to determine the boundaries between each fraction. And the boundaries are given in this chart in terms of the size of particles in millimeters. There are three different systems that we can use is unified soil classification system, British system, and Australian system. For this example, we're going to use Australian standards. So you will see that the boundary between finest particles such as clay and silt, it will be 0.002 millimeters. The difference between silt and sand are determined by the boundary of 0.075 millimeters, and sand and gravel are defined by the boundary of 2.36 millimeters. If you don't remember this, you can still look at this chart. It's available in all textbooks. Also, in this course of soil mechanics, we typically deal with gravel, sand, silt, and clay, and we don't really deal with particles that are larger than gravel size. So let's look at this curve again and determine the percentage of each fraction. So the first thing that we will do is we will determine how much sand and gravel in it. And we remember that the boundary is 2.36 millimeters. So we're going to draw a line. It should be a straight line. So this is the boundary between gravel. Everything that is on the right hand side here is going to be gravel. And here we're going to have sand. And the second boundary, it's 0.075 millimeters, which I'm going to draw now. So this boundary will define the sand and fines. To find out how much gravel in this soil, we're going to look at the percentage passing. And we also draw a line and see. We'll see that it's about 32%. This means that 32% of soil finer than the sieve 2.36 millimeters, which means that the remaining is 100 minus 32, 68% retains in the sieve, which is 2.36 millimeters. This means that gravel, it's 68%. So this part, it's 68%. Now we're going to look at the second boundary here. And we'll see that in this case, the point is about 1%. So we had 32%. That was finer than 2.36 millimeters. And we subtract 1%, that is finer than 0.075 millimeters. It's going to give us 31%, which is sand. So in this case, sand, it's 31%. And the 1% that is finer than 0.075 millimeters is going to be fines. At this point, we don't know if it's 1% of silt or it's clay or it's half-half, we don't know. And we're not really interested in this unless the amount of fines in soil is 10% or higher. But in this case, the amount of fines, it's only 1%. So we just go with 1% of fines. The second step in classifying coarse grain soil is to determine its gradation. So remember that it only works for coarse grain material like gravel and sand, and we don't need it for plastic soil, plastic clay or silt. So let's look at three different arrangements of solid particles. The one here on the left hand side is called well-graded soil, when we have particles of all different sizes. We have big particles, medium size and small particles. So this is what we call well-graded soil. The one that is marked as B, we call it poorly graded soil. So for this soil, typically we have only one dominant size. It can be either all big particles, medium size or small particles, but it's only one size that is dominant. And the last one is a gap graded structure, when we have one size that is missing. So if we look at this diagram, you will see that we have big particles of solids and we have also small particles, but we don't have a medium size here. So this is what we call gap graded soil. The next step is to determine the soil gradation. For this reason, we would like to know two coefficients, coefficient of uniformity and coefficient of curvature. You will see that in these two equations, we have symbols as D10, D30, and D60. We'll get these numbers from the curve. D10 would show you the size of particles which passing through 10%. D30 will be the size of particles passing through D30. And this is going to be D60. So we will see where the curve crosses this D10 line. And this will give us the size of 0.6 millimeters. So I'm going to run it here that D10 is equal 0.6 millimeters. Next we'll do D30. We can use a ruler to perform this operation. So approximately 2.1 millimeter. So D30 is equal 2.1 millimeter. And D60 it will give us approximately 5.5 millimeters. So in this case, D60, it will be 5.5 millimeters. Next step is to calculate both coefficients, coefficient of uniformity and coefficient of curvature. So for coefficient of uniformity, we'll have 5.5 divided by 0.6 will approximately give us 9.2. And for the coefficient of curvature, we will have 2.1 in the power of 2 divided by 0.6 times 5.5 will approximately give us 1.34. Okay, now what we're going to do, we're going to write down all the information that we know. So I'm going to write this coefficient that we just obtained. Coefficient of uniformity, it's 9.2. Coefficient of curvature, it's equal to 1.34. And another information that we need is the amount of each fraction. I will have gravel about 68%. We have sand of about 31%, and we have fines about 1%. So altogether should be 100%. Just make sure it makes 100%. Now we're going to classify the soil, and we're going to use ASH to classification system. So for this classification system, the coarse material is defined as material that has fines from 0 to 35%. So in this chart, F means fines. And this is a very important thing that you need to remember. We're going to use it very often. F stands for fines. G stands for gravel. And S stands for sand. So this chart is actually easy to use. What we need to do is we need to look at the percentage of each fraction, gravel, sand, and fines, and we'll do some comparison. So we'll start with the top and go all the way to the bottom. So we first look at the top box, and it says percentage of fines from 0 to 35. I will say yes, because we have only 1%. Then we're going to down, and we're going to compare gravel and sand. We'll see what we have more. Do we have more gravel? In this case, we're going to the left. Or we have sand, then we'll go to the right. So we'll notice that we have more gravel. Gravel 68%, so we're going this way to this box. After that, I will have to check the amount of fines again. You see F stands for fines again. So the percentage that we have here, it's 1%. So percentage of fines will fall in the first box, this one, because it says from 0 to 5%. So we know that it's gravel. Our soil is gravel. And the symbol for the soil is going to be G. Now you will see that we can go to the left, and it says GW. Or we can go to the right, and it says GPA. Which one will we go? We're going to decide based on the gradation. And for this purpose, we need to know coefficient of uniformity and coefficient of curvature. And we're going to see if it's well-graded soil or it's poorly graded soil. So W stands for well-graded, and P stands for poorly graded. To do that, we need to look at the criteria, and you see that here in this box we have criteria for two types of soil, gravel and sand. We already know that we deal with gravel, that's what we decided, so we're going to look at this criteria. So for soil to be well graded, the coefficient of curvature needs to be in the range from 1 to 3, and in this case, yes. The coefficient of curvature that we have is 1.34, so it falls in this range. And the coefficient of uniformity should be more than 4, and we have 9.2. So in this case, we can say that the gravel is well graded, and the classification of this soil is going to be GW. Let's say that one of the coefficients actually, it doesn't fall into the range, in the range it's supposed to be. In this case, the soil is not well graded, it's going to be poorly graded, and in that case, the answer will be GP. But in our case, we see that the gravel is well graded, because both coefficients, coefficient of curvature and coefficient of uniformity, satisfy the requirement for well graded soil. Thanks for watching this tutorial. You see that the procedure is not very difficult. What you need to do is just more practice. Thanks, and do more practice.